So I heard an argument on First Things First today that we need to revisit the Tom Brady, Bill Belichick argument. Why? Why do we need to revisit it? Why? Because the Patriots are having a good year? That makes no sense. Okay, two things can be true. Bill Belichick can be a GOAT coach and Tom Brady can be a GOAT quarterback at the same time. Why is Tom Brady the only quarterback that is under a microscope? Okay, why do we only do this to Tom Brady? And let me explain what I mean. Okay, Joe Montana won his last Super Bowl in 1989, he won his last Super Bowl. Okay, 1990, he goes to a conference championship. 1991, Steve Young takes over. 1992, he went to a conference championship, Steve Young. And then in 1993, he won a Super Bowl. Does that mean Joe Montana is no good because Steve Young came in and went to a conference championship and went to a Super Bowl? Does that mean that Joe Montana is no good all of a sudden? No, that makes no sense. Patrick Mahomes, before he took over the Chiefs, in 2015, the Chiefs had 11 wins. In 2016, they had 12 wins. In 2017, they had 10 wins. That year, by the way, they were ranked fourth offensively. They had over 4,600 yards from the line of scrimmage with or between Albert Ramos, Tyreek Hill, Travis Kelce, and Kareem Hunt. Travis Kelce was already catching for 1,000 yards. Hill was already catching for 1,000 yards. And like I said, they were the fourth highest ranked offense. So the Chiefs went to the playoffs 3 years in a row, won 10 games or more 3 years in a row before Patrick Mahomes showed up. Andy Reid as a head coach had already been to the playoffs for 13 years without Patrick Mahomes. He went to two conference championships and he went to a Super Bowl without Patrick Mahomes. Does that mean Andy Reid doesn't need Patrick Mahomes? Is that proof because Andy Reid went to the playoffs for 13 years without Patrick Mahomes that he doesn't need Patrick Mahomes? Okay, it's ridiculous. Phil Jackson, okay, the head coach for Michael Jordan. Michael Jordan won 6 championships with Phil Jackson. Then Phil Jackson hooked up with Kobe Bryant and Shaquille O'Neal and won 5 more championships. The fact that Phil Jackson went on to win 5 more championships with 2 other players other than Michael Jordan, is that proof that Michael Jordan's no good? That Phil Jackson did not need Michael Jordan? Okay, it's getting to the point where it's getting ridiculous. The last year Brett Favre played for the Packers, he led them to an NFC championship. Okay, then Aaron Rodgers took over and a year or two later won a Super Bowl with the same team. The fact that the Packers went to an NFC championship, I believe a year or two before Rodgers won a Super Bowl, is that proof that Aaron Rodgers isn't needed with the Green Bay Packers? Like, why is Tom Brady the only one that's penalized because his previous coach might go to the playoffs? Is that the standard for Bill Belichick now? All he has to do is get the Patriots to the playoffs, and that's proof, right, that he didn't need Tom Brady because he takes a team to the playoffs. Is that the standard? I'm just trying to figure out what's the standard, because Tom Brady went to another team with another coaching staff, with another system, in another city during a pandemic when he didn't even get a preseason in time to practice with his team, literally got kicked out of the park, and he won a Super Bowl with that team. So why is the bar so low for Coach Bill Belichick and the bar so high for Tom Brady? Why does Bill only have to go to the playoffs and Tom apparently has to win 2 Super Bowls now? Okay, I'm trying to make sense of all of this. Why does Nick Wright believe that because Bill Belichick is getting the Patriots to the playoffs, maybe because they have 3 tough games coming up, right? They have the Colts and the Bills twice. So we'll see. I'm not saying they're not going to make the playoffs. I'm on board with the Patriots now. I believe they're a good team. Okay, but I don't know. I have no idea what's going to happen with, you know, when they play the Colts and the Bills twice. I have no idea. The Bills are a very difficult team to read, and the Colts are a solid team. We'll see. But what I'm trying to understand is, why is Tom Brady the only quarterback that we do this to? Why is he the only player that we do this to? Why is Nick Wright so intent on going after Tom Brady? I'll tell you why. Okay, I'll tell you why. He has an agenda. Nick Wright is the new Max Kellerman. If you remember, Max Kellerman invented the cliff theory. Remember that? And that's because Max Kellerman was trying to take Tom Brady down because he was sick that everyone was calling Tom Brady the GOAT. And now he himself admits that Tom Brady is the GOAT. Nick Wright is a huge Patrick Mahomes fan. And what he's trying to do, is tear Tom Brady down so that he can sell everyone on Patrick Mahomes. That's what he's trying to do. That's why Tom Brady has been held to this impossible standard that no other quarterback is being held to. You know, this got me thinking, and I started thinking, wow, if you really think about it, imagine being Tom Brady. Like, really, for a second, take your view of this world and just put it aside and try and put yourself into the mind of Tom Brady. Imagine the pressure. You're Tom Brady. You've been to 10 Super Bowls. You've won 7. You're number one in passing yards, passing touchdowns, regular season, postseason, and Super Bowl. You've broken over 550 to 70-something records, and you continue to break records. You've won Super Bowls with 2 different teams. Your team this year is 8-3, tied for or in first place in your division, 1 game behind in the NFC conference. You have a good chance of winning the number one seed in their conference. They have a good chance. And your team is on a path to potentially compete to win a second Super Bowl. And yet everyone questions you. Okay, everyone still questions Tom Brady. Apparently, winning one Super Bowl aside from Bill Belichick means absolutely nothing. You see, this is why I know he's the GOAT. Because it's easy to get that one. Okay, let me rephrase that. It's not easy for an athlete to win a Super Bowl. That's very difficult. What I'm saying is to sustain it. A lot of quarterbacks win one. A lot of teams win one. Sustaining the success is another story. Because in today's era, you have to deal with social media. That's one of the reasons why, when it comes to the LeBron argument and MJ argument, even though I have MJ as the GOAT, I feel like LeBron can still pass them. In other words, it's close to me. I have MJ a little higher, but I have LeBron right there. Because Michael Jordan didn't have to live through this era like LeBron does, okay? And if you think about it, all the things Michael went through, right? The fights, the gambling, you know, he had a ton of stuff happen in his career that in today's era would have just been brutalized on social media. Like, Michael Jordan would have been destroyed on Facebook, YouTube, Twitter. And we have no idea how he would have responded. We just don't. We can assume, but we don't know really. There's no way to prove it. And LeBron has had to deal with that. He's had to deal with that. He's the only other athlete that goes through what Tom Brady goes through. He's the only other athlete alive playing sports that understands Tom Brady. He's the only one. They're held to these impossible standards. And every time they win or prove something, the haters move the goalpost. And now when it comes to Bill, lower the standard. And when it comes to Tom Brady, move the goalpost. All Bill has to do is get the Patriots to the playoffs. But Tom, he's got to win a second Super Bowl. It's getting ridiculous, right? It's getting to the point where it's just ridiculous. People need to take a deep breath, calm down. 2 things can be true. Coach Bill Belichick can be a GOAT coach. Tom Brady can be a GOAT quarterback. Nothing Bill does, okay? He can go 0-10 for the next 10 years. He's still going to be the GOAT coach. You know, nothing Tom Brady does, He's still going to be the GOAT quarterback for many years. It's going to be a long time until somebody catches him. Maybe even never. But even if you want to delve into it, I know one thing from a factual perspective. When we remove all emotion, Coach Belichick has close to 8 years coaching without Tom Brady. Keywords, head coach. He has a losing record, and he's won one playoff game without Tom. Tom has close to 2 years without Bill. He's won one Super Bowl, and this year, his team is in first place in his division. His team is 8-3. They're one game back from securing a first-round bye, right? The number one seed in the NFC Conference. Tom Brady's number one passing yards, passing touchdowns year-to-date. He's still in the MVP conversation in spite of a so-so game versus the Colts, right? And his team is doing good. Like, those are facts. You can delve into it any which way you want and try and stir it up any which way you want. Coach BB has almost 8 years without Tom, one playoff win, right? That's just a fact. Tom Brady has almost two years away from Bill, Super Bowl victory, and it looks like they're going to compete for another one this year again. Those are facts. Those are just facts. They're not up for debate. That is factually true. So, and in my opinion, the 8 years doesn't matter. The 2 years doesn't matter. Tom Brady is a GOAT quarterback. Coach Bill is a GOAT coach. Stop trying to weaponize the Patriots' success as a weapon against Tom Brady. It's getting ridiculous. If you're going to do it to Tom, do it to Patrick Mahomes, do it to Joe Montana, do it to Aaron Rodgers. But the media will never do that. You know why? They're not jealous of Aaron Rodgers. They're not jealous of Patrick Mahomes. They're not jealous of Joe Montana. There is one player in football that everyone is jealous of right now, and that's why they hate on him, and his name is Tom Brady.
Hey everyone, thank you for watching SP Sports today. Please don't forget to click the subscribe button down below. This way you are notified when we post new videos. Also, if you have a moment, leave a comment and check out our other videos.